Okay, hope this works. Check. Test. Awesome. Is everything awesome? Hope everything's awesome. I am on air, but I must test. Oh, here we go. Alive. Yes, indeed. Let's watch it from here, maybe. That'll work better. Teach. Go ahead and start this. Right. Here we go. Alright, cool. Oh! Looks like I was in the middle of a game that I am now going to have to restart from the beginning. Let's see, is the picture okay? This 720, but why am I? I think that's normal. Yeah, it looks normal enough to me. I'll just double check my Yeah, I think it'll be okay. That's good enough. It looks good. I think that's what matters. Let me back out of this here. Okay. Oop. All right. I think we'll just. I could keep the restore point if I wanted to. I'll just reset. You know. Controller, I need my Wii U Pro controller here. Ube. Creepy. Whippets Kojiro underscore S. Thank you for joining us here. I'm gonna watch the intro. Might as well watch the intro. It is Halloween. Is it, after all? Whip it good. Before we can whip it, we must need a source for whipping. Why are we whipping? This is why we're whipping. God, this music is like... I'm getting chills listening to this. It's so good.
Every 100 years, the forces of good mysteriously start to weaken. Thus, the power of Dracula starts to revive itself. His power grows stronger and stronger every 100 years.
Oh, are you kidding? Yeah, the ambiance in this is amazeballs.
Dracula has revived many times. However, his sinister actions have been consistently thwarted by the Belmont family.
This tune comes up right before you fight Dracula too, it's so good.
It's been 100 years since the last confrontation between Dracula and the Belmont family. But now the serenity of Transylvania is being threatened by destructive forces.
Good, good translation for a SNES launch window title.
In the dark and eerie night, Dracula rose from his grave when he power over the country as poor Transylvanians. Once again, Simon Belmont is called upon to kill Dracula. He told his victim he could, and he just looks out.
says once again, but pretty much will be telling them any S castle. Thank you, whoever just joined us. I see we have three people. Any hoots. This is Super Castlevania 4. In my mind, one of the greatest of the Castlevania. Okay. Let's go ahead and start here. We'll check our options. I don't think we... Yeah, we're good. Stereo. Wait, we're set. Into your name. Oh, what should I... forget if there's any secrets or not, but I'll take whatever... I'll take whatever name the chat wants me to. Otherwise, I can... You know what, I'll just get this going, because the chat is delayed. I'll just put my... Rick. Love that intro. Use the whip. Last time was 100 years ago. I believe so. The last time was with Trevor Belmont. Castlevania 3 with Trevor Belmont is like a prequel to Simon Belmont's story. And it's not Castlevania unless I am walking on stairs. Greatest thing about this game. Not even kidding. Alright, hopefully I didn't miss anything. Effects here. This is like one of the games to really take advantage of most of it. I feel like there might be a secret here, but I might be wrong. Yeah, no. Rusty. Alright, enjoy yourself and use this. One of the best Castlevania has to offer. Thing about Castlevania 4's music, I like put a great length to just what makes it so amazing and all that jazz. On my personal website, if you ever want to check it out, patrickwachowski.com. Alright. Under the Pixelitis tab, I have my old liner notes tutorial where I just go to town. I'm talking about video game music that's near and dear to me. Lords of Shadow, but I much prefer it to this one. This guy. force sounds low in comparison. I can... Is that better? Let me know if my voice is better now. I think I'm talking pretty far away from the mic, but maybe it's better now, let me know. If not, I'll do some tooling. Whatever, I'll take the holy water. Ooh, I got those annoying horse heads. Rah. I gotta come back. Alright, good. Yeah, I think the microphone was too far away from my mouth, so... Pointing that out. Stop what? No, okay, yeah, Medusa heads, sure, I'll use that. So these Medusa heads are far less troublesome than the NES ones. It's also not as creepy looking. Oh my god, die already. Maybe their concern was that 8 direction whip was made it too easy, but I don't know, like, it just felt liberating after, like, 3 games with more clunky controls. It was definitely a breath of fresh air. Alright, let's do this. You want some? Oh! Yeah, what now? Also, you gotta pose when you get the orb. So let's pose. Yeah! Oh, I love that. You get to see sprite animations that you normally can't see because they're so quick. You Ghosts and Goblins music! Silly organ, right here. This is another good tune. I mean, this whole soundtrack is incredible, but the Stage 2 music's really... See that? The cool bass. Yeah, I got the axe. Alright. Oh yeah, Rockin' Chocobo, here to bring the rock in Rocktober. Welcome. Indeed, it's Castlevania. It's good stuff. Ooh! Not anything good? Awesome. I reached it. No! Oh, I can't. Wait. Forgot about that. Is OP in this game. Something I've never been good about is keeping the 2 and 3, the Roman numeral 2 and 3s, before dying. Just always, I always lose them. OP now. Don't mind me as I pick up onomatopoeia to music. Ooh. Oh! Alright, I don't need that health. I like that sound effect. this part. Leap, I can fall in the mud, but it's not recommended. Classic thing here. You have the L-powered cross, you can literally kill Medusa as soon as she ends here. If she's not too bad. Yeah, the bosses really don't ramp up in this game until, like, I would say... I know, something Gra, Slow Gra, or whatever it's called. That one's, kind of, problem, but... a lot of the early bosses are easy-peasy, for the most part. And death, of course. Definitely Gra laughing at her. Alright. Got our, cave wall turkey. Always good. Hitbox on that thing. I love them hitboxes. There we go. Seriously though, like, dodge walking, like, bring that back. One good thing that Rondo introduced in Symphony of the Night in comparison is, if you accidentally pick up another item, you can have a chance to pick up the old one before it disappears. Also, you can backflip in Rondo of Blood, which is really OP. Yeah, the Trick Manor, although that has my favorite track in this entire game. Trick Manor is just... oh god. Yep, and she's dead. A little sloppy, but... I'm no MLG player. Ah, Master Hand. Yay, I got the two. Let's see how long I can keep the two. Oh, more cross, oh well. A lot of diversity in the enemies too, which is cool. Like, diversity in the environment, the enemies, it's just like so fresh. Interesting story about this though is, I have a roommate who also works in the same place I do. And he, used to work at a company which housed the director of this game. And naturally, both of us are hardcore fans, and so is my roommate. And so he would, like, bring that up to the guy and be like, yo, for Castlevania 4 is, like, my jam. It's, like, so important. And the director doesn't think about it the same way that the fans do. But I guess, kind of a humble thing, but it's also, like, I guess it was a very stressful time in the director's life, which is why he doesn't think of it the same way as Castlevania fans would. Run ruined, yeah. Thankfully, I didn't specify that it's, I did not specify that it's a, run, a speed run or anything. It's a fun run. Or, Awesome Games Done... AGDN. Awesome Games Done Normally. Oh, this music's wonderful. Waterfall music, too. It's like, oh my god. Feels... yeah, but this is, like, so atmospheric. Let's see. Is he sad that they're not gonna make any more Pachinko? No, I'm sure he doesn't care. He left Konami long ago. I think he left in, like, the late 90s or something like that, so... not with the company anymore. Yeah, he does not... house the same feelings about Castlevania 4 as the fans do. I guess it's different, holy lag, Batman. It's different when you work on a game, sometimes. You recall kind of painful memories. If it was, like, a troubled development, or... struggle. Yay, secrets. Alright, more crosses. Water almost trolled me. Oh yeah. All about the wall chicken. Yeah, he doesn't work at Konami anymore, but he works at where my roommate used to work, which is Voltage Entertainment. They're a mobile Japanese games company. They do mostly like I forget the correct genre term for it, but like those type of dating games, those dating mobile games. What are those called again? There's a specific Japanese term for them. Maybe you guys might know. But shows my ignorance of that genre. And mobile gaming. Although I do want to give mobile gaming a chance. Me personally, I don't play too many mobile games. I do like Terra Battle. Miss Walker. Terra Battle is good stuff. I don't think I'm missing anything. Yeah, dating games. What are those called though? There's some really popular ones, and they have there's a term for them. I probably missed something. Capcom Japan actually is making a mobile dating game, and I'm hearing great things about it. I don't know if it's out yet, but it looks good actually. I can't really speak to the LF6 or anything. That's all Japan. Done the contra effect where the screen has moved up, so I drop here, it's yeah, this waterfall music is super BOF6 is a spam affair. There we go. I wanna make sure I don't pick up anything else. About those hearts for sure. Moody. Love it. I get chills listening to this. One of those, like, must-own soundtracks. I think it goes, like, the soundtrack itself you could probably get for, like, 20-something bucks on CD Japan right now. Thinking about doing it. Ugh, I knew that was gonna happen. Gosh, darn it. Anything on that side? Style bass. Those old school ones. Ah, crap. See, this is what I get for talking. I already saw you, bastard. I was wondering when my first death was gonna kick in. Here we go. Doing better. That eye. I'm just imagining like a Japanese jazz musician just playing that upright bass. Like some secluded Japanese bar. No cigarettes, alcohol, normal day. That's what this vibe gives me. Ah, dagger again. That's what I get for not using my sub-weapons. Yeah, I'm bad about that. Even with Mega Man.
Oh, no. I hate these guys. No!
Bad about them. This is so annoying. Yeah, I'm totally... Really? Oh, man. Yeah, I am totally guilty of not focusing on my sub-weapon. Holy crap. Take it easy. Yeah, I hate those water squirting things. What are they called? Sahagins or something? What's their name? Arr, this. Troll dagger. That is an apt term for the dagger in this game. I never want it. Nobody asked for the troll dagger. But it just it wants you to pick it up. And there it goes again. MLG Pro, this is. See that waterfall effect? That's so awesome. Like, this is a 1991 game, people, on Super Nintendo. Alright, I'm good. Whack that weed and keep going. Ah, no money bags. Ooh. That was a close one. Here we go. Yay, axe. Just what we need for the boss of this area. Is there anything here? No. Moonwalk up. Yeah, let's moonwalk. Maybe this guy, except bigger. Oh, this is a cool change up. Care of him before I get any flip ups here. Come on. There we go. I stole those hearts, but that's okay. There we go. Yeah, piano. Yo. Slowdown in this game actually helps. Kind of gives you time to react in a way. It is a feature. Dagnabbit. Alright, we got our chicken, which should be good. Hopefully. Oop. Careful. Alright, where does he come from? Yep. The axe. Yeah, I did it. Pose. Do. Vorpal Vipers can be wrecked as well. Three cross. Oh, I bet they can. You can never keep those Roman numerals though, Dagnabbit. Yes, Trick Manor. My favorite track in this game. So I can forgive the immense difficulty of this section. So good. Drumming in this too. So good. Yay, the two. Those creepy buildings. Also, the door creaking sounds in this track, so amazing. It's just brilliant. Prepare to die. And that upright bass again. Yeah, Konami had like one of the best game composers in that era. Pure genius. Pure genius, and it's a shame that most people don't know him by name. Yeah, I don't want that. No way in heck. Here we go. And I knew that was gonna happen. Actually, platforming this segment is a little tougher when you've got... See, I'm using a Wii U Pro controller. And, it is wireless, and there may be input lag, so... It's a little tricky. Gotta time it just right. There we go. I think if I mash on B, that should be okay. Like that. Come here. Yeah. Oh yeah, don't get knocked back during this segment. That would suck. Alright. Far so good. Also, this is another example of amazing game design. They introduced those tricky platforms as a little bit of practice, and then they up the ante on them as you go. The first few times, you didn't really have enemies to mess around with them, but then they start throwing them in. Alright, here we go. This is a skull, right? Yes, I can't remember this. Ah, this part's annoying. Ugh, creepy. Ah, it wasn't so bad. I like the little hop and skip there. Alright. Now we get to see some, witness some rad mode 7, Rexel. I'm glad somebody knows the names of these enemies and bosses. I only know like Medusa Head and Eagle or whatever those pumping things are called. Get out of here. God, how many of these are there? Oop! Alright. Mortal 7. Indeed. Ready. We just gotta swing it. And that was a fail, huh? Obviously needed to... obviously I needed to swing a bit more than that. Yeah, it wasn't even the Medusa head that was trouble, it was damn spikes. I love how this is inhumanly impossible. Like, no human could do that unless this is a special whip with a switch on it. Allow you to do something like that. Anyway. Okay, good, it's still one hit on these guys. I don't have an axe, but who needs it? Who needs sub weapons? I got my vampire killer whip. Alright. Yep. Alright. Oh yeah, I do remember that mode 7 thing with Mega Man 7. Now available on the Wii U and 3DS. New 3DS, I should specify. Oh. Oh, right. I forgot that was gonna happen. I was gonna swing into the pit. There we go. Now this part's amazing. This is some really sick mode 7. There's lots of slowdown, but it's like okay. I love how the music, it's a little subdued here. feel like in this part, this is like my favorite part of this song. I love how the track is. There are new elements to this track as you progress to the stage, through the stage, and that's such a genius thing to do. Oops. I should stop talking and just get through this. Alright, Kojiro, you have a great night. Thanks for hopping on. This is a bit tricky. Mega Drive, thanks for hopping on. Look at all that blast processing in this castle. Indeed. Much blast processing. Can I step up there? I don't think so. Yeah, no. Okay, this part's a little tricky. Here we go. Probably could have gone down there, but that's okay. Ooh! What happened? Oh, damn. I'm on my last life. I may have to, I do have a save state I could use, but I'm gonna be classic and not do that. Unless you guys are okay with me using save state. Oh god. No. Alright, that was close. There's a secret over there? I don't think I've ever gone that way. I also don't have much time, but I'm going to risk it. Nope, not worth it. Missing out on a lot of secrets, aren't I? It's okay. This is a very, very cool segment, though. Ah, the cross. Oh well. Make do without it. And if I get a game over, I can try again. Right. Oh. And maybe I'll go this way now. This part of the song perfectly encapsulates the tricky aspect of this manor, hence Trick Manor. What's over here? Ooh! Why would I want to go there? And of course, everything's on that side now. Trick Manor. It tricks you. I still don't understand why that exists. I guess it's, again, to trick me. 92 seconds, that's not good. I better get a move on here. 86 seconds. Oh man, I'm not gonna make it now. I'm dawdling for too long. Unless I can get to a new area in time. Let's hope. Let's trick. Ay, ay, ay. 1 second. Is there a way out of here? Oh god. Oh no, oh no, no, no. Thanks. I got 4 lives. I'll be okay now. Forget if there was a specific strategy to that, or if you're supposed to just keep going up. Can't remember. I came that way, I see. I get it now. I completely forgot how that section of the game worked. Pro Castlevania player, I am not. Want to head right, got it, okay. Gotta remember, it's not Metroidvania. There's only one direction, and that direction is forward. And there we go. I just gotta learn to mash B during that section and I'll be okay. There we go. Get good. Yeah. For sure. That is the best pro tip you can give in any Castlevania game is get good. Sloppy, but better than before. Alright. Yeah, I would say this is by far one of the tougher platforming segments. This game really tests your metal. I messed up though. I feel like the game expects you to swing over into that gap there. eBay because I had gotten it on the Wii, so I assumed, oh hey, I have it on the Wii, don't need it on the Super Nintendo anymore. Big mistake. It's pretty rare now. It was for a hefty price. dice, I think. Alright, keep going right. Castlevania 3 next. That was actually... CV3 was the second game I ever streamed. And that was the first time I beat it. Was on a live stream. That must have been... Oh my god. I think that was in like 2009, I want to say. That was before the days of like Twitch and stuff. I would go on Justin TV or something. Or Ustream, actually. It was Ustream. And I just had this like... really hokey webcam hooked up pointing at my TV screen, and that's how people watched me play. It was really funny. First game I ever live streamed was Super Ghouls and Ghosts, and that was also the first time I had ever beaten that game. Alright. Here. I forget, is there a right way out here, or do I keep going up? I guess I keep going up. CV3 is brutal, but I beat it. I feel like half that time was fighting Dracula. He is no—he's no cakewalk in that game. I'll tell you. Yeah, CV3. I would like to live stream again, but if I was to live stream it, I really want to get the Famicom version. My personal. Oh, great. Now they're faster. This is wonderful. That's not so bad, you just keep holding right. Yes, CV3, if I'm gonna play it's gonna be the Famicom version because it's easier, and it also has better music. Unfortunately though, the Famicom version goes away. Hefty sum online. Maybe with the Christmas money or something, I could get that one. And of course, it's not Halloween anymore, but that's right. CV3 is made by Kiss. Well, that's the funny thing, is the US version, you take more hits than you do in the Japanese version. So somehow the Famicom version is a lot more tolerable. Oh yeah, I forgot this guy. Mode 7. This guy's actually part of the background, if I'm not mistaken. He's not a sprite. Explains his, increasing size. Yeah. Yeah! That's his best pose yet.
Mode 7.
Stage V. Ah, okay, this is the pathway leading up to Castlevania. And the music reflects that. It's like, oh man. That's the great part. It's like, this is like, this music's telling you, hey, guess what? It's just the beginning. Like, you're not in the castle yet. Funny thing, right? CV1 starts you right at the castle. CV4 is like, no. You gotta trek through some crazy Transylvanian wilderness to get to the castle. Right to onto Dracula's doorstep. I think if we knock it, let us see. Ooh. Those guys were never fun, especially the CD3, they were tricky. One hit. Troll dagger. I just saved it this way. I could probably do this a lot easier. There we go. Leemen, that's it. Not Igor. Leemen. I forgot the proper term for those guys. Wasn't Igor a Fleeman boss in what you call in Castlevania 1? If I recall correctly. Ooh. Now that creepy ass music. That's a cool segue. Oh crap, I have 40 seconds. Get going. I believe the statues here were altered in the US release. Pretty sure one of them was like nude or something. Oh. Alright, we're inside the castle. Cue even more awesome music. Go away, Dad. That's a very classical regal style too. I think it was the statue there that was altered in the US. Yeah, it didn't have the boob wasn't concealed. Oh, and then it gets all funky here. No. Never mind, I thought this music got funky later on. And I thought this was just an intro. We truly are the Castlevania. After defeating Dracula. And then turns to... I don't know. Who's he turned to? He killed everybody. And it looks at the camera and goes, you know, you really are the special thing. Castlevania is all of us. This is another one of my favorite tracks in this game. Very awesome piano here. One of those tracks I would love to hear someone play on piano. By heart as balls, but... tricky platform. The boss in this one was pretty creepy. I just barely got that. Did you see that? It was like the tip of his toe touched the platform. New Castlevania confirmed 2116. New Castlevania confirmed when the next eclipse happens. There'll be a Dawn of Sorrow sequel or something. I always thought it was kind of cool that Aria of Sorrow and Dawn of Sorrow were like futuristic. These guys are the worst. On those things. I hate those things. I don't think you can destroy those things. That guy is the worst, and I hate that one. I hate all these ghosts. Definitely the spookiest level we've been in, though. So, Toggin' Dawes, everybody.
Excellent.
Yeah, the Sorrow games are excellent. Dawn of Sorrow is probably one of my favorite of the portable Castlevanias. I had such a great time playing that one. Would love to give Aria another go. That's a lot of people's favorites of the Metro games. Butler dude always comes up under this time. Maybe you can. You hit him again. There we go. So annoying. There we go. Six people. Nice. Glad more Castlevania fans are watching. Oop. It's gonna follow me, so I should take care of it. Grunting Butler, that's my name for this enemy. No butlers. I feel like there might be something here. Is there like a seat? Yeah, isn't that a switch? No? Is my mind playing tricks on me? I could have sworn you could, like, open up that area. Maybe I'm wrong. Axe man. Let me ask you a question, Hoho. There we go. We go. Call this residual whip. When you flick it at them like that. Alright. Nope. Oh! Damn it. Those jerks. Yeah, the old school Axons are really, really bad. Here there is. Almost easier to duck under their axe throws. Anyway, I made a boo-boo there. I was expecting them to throw Medusa heads at me. Go away. Seriously. Come over. So failing right now. I almost don't want to look at the chat. You're all probably making fun of me. If I can find a wall chicken soon. There we go. Yeah, yeah, correct me if I'm wrong, like, I really swear that you can open that area to the left. Yeah, the ghost dancers are the bosses here, they're very sleepy. Damn you! Doesn't that look like a switch down there? Like, there has to be a trick to this. No? I feel like you can get there somehow. Let me look up a walkthrough. Damn it. Why? Why'd that happen? What? Get out of here. Get out of here! That makes perfect, guys. Alright, let me... My mess up happened because of this part. Focus. There. Oh, that was close. Things like that, that I can attack an axe armor from below. The reason why this game is bad. There we go. Hunting butlers. Ah. Jerk face. During this part now, that'll really set me back. There we go. That was so close. Ah, these things are creepy. Ah! Very macabre moment. Do that piano. We're almost there, I think. Oop. Man, that was a big dodge by me. Ah, there's a skeleton. Let me show up. Oop. Get the killer tables. Ah, oh, I forgot about those. These are crazy. It's a long stage, man. Oh, jerk faces. Jerk faces. All of these jerk faces. This is a very Castlevania 1 area. There's a Castlevania 1 level that was just like this. Gauntlet right here. Just go under. What's the deal with that stuff? What's his problem? Oh. Oh, I see. I get it now. It teaches you crouch walking. Up we go. That's not a dark Whirling Coffins. What about you? Alright, we're almost there. Table time. I'm gonna give that table the satisfaction. Ah, the dancers. I hate you. Oh, no. There we go. Glad I had that. Ah, this part's crazier and crazier. By the minute. Okay. Chicken here, please tell me yes. Yes. One up, okay, that's good too. I like that. Yay, chicken. Alright, I got this. I got a 2, I got an X. Alright. Damn it! I was so close to. All right. Thankfully, I'm pretty close to the boss now. Got a few tries. No two, but again, who needs two? A lot of cool and fresh skin. Please tell me those are American names. Hola, Asu.
It's gold, Jerry. That's absolute gold.
Oh. Alright, two hits. Two hits is all it takes.
Jerk Jason.
No sub weapon, huh? Oh, I can keep getting one-ups here. That's good. That's very good. I'm happy. Too bad I can't have a sub-weapon for this, but I think I can do it. Done it before. I've beaten this game, like, twice before, so... God, they hit so hard. Oh my god. Jeez. I don't really know the pattern with them. I just kind of hit them. That's me with every Castlevania boss. I don't have patience. I just want to throw everything at them. As long as I can keep getting those one-ups, then I'm fine. I can keep trying as many times as I need to. But if you have any MLG strats for me, for that boss, I'm all ears, because I can't remember how I ever managed to beat them. Oops. That's a tricky part. Yeah, one-ups. Endless one-ups. That makes me very happy. Okay, let's try this again. What is their pattern? I can do this all night. I got infinite lives. Once the game decides to take away that one-up secret, that's not good. I wonder how a speedrunner deals with those guys. They're pretty tricky. There we go. Yep, one-ups keep coming. One-ups keep coming, and they don't stop coming, and they don't stop. Okay.
Yeah! Merciless.
You see that? That's a speedrun strat right there.
Oh, yeah.
Feels good. That's the last of my Mountain Dew. Alright, what's next? Throw it at me. Whatever you got, just throw it at me. The treasure area? Oh no, no, I remember this part. Actually, I'm not sure if I'm a fan of this area. Books. Those books are spooky. I feel like Dark Souls took a lot of inspiration from a level like this. Switched into maximum overdrive. Oh yeah. Feels good to do good. See, my strategy works on that boss. It was, I just threw myself at it. I was like, can't stop, won't stop. With the good. That is honestly the best, my best strat is whip it good. Whipping it good in this game. Can't whip it good. Can't slam with the best and jam with the rest. That'd be another great stream, by the way, Barclay Gaiden stream. Be hilarious. Laugh at the flying axes. Okay, down we go. Oop. You know, those guys were the absolute worst in Castlevania 3. There was a stair area just like this in Castlevania 3, except it was those guys and Medusa heads at the same time. That's the part I would always get stuck on. You like put me off from the game for the longest time. There we go. Oh, that was uncalled for. Did you see that there? Michael Jackson, yeah. Go down here, I guess. Yeah. Ah, whatever. Dagger's a dagger. I love how I can, like, freeze up their frames there, just by flicking the whip at them. Oh! I don't remember this. Loading books. No! That sucks. Okay, I start right here, that's good. There it is. There we go. They don't throw bones, right? That would suck if they threw bones. There we go. I'm any day now. There we go. Sorry. Bloomington Michelettle. Stop that. That's creepy. Forgot about that. Creepy. beast torture attack. Would it attack me? I feel like it does. Maybe not. Ooh. That was a spook. Is that a feral cat? Or seems like one. Alright. How dare you? How dare he? Doing solid so far. Look at that. Oh my god. Yeah, 2 is nice, but freaking would be even nicer. These portraits. Whoa! I forgot about this. Link to the past look alike. Oh god. I knew that wasn't gonna work out. I can either do... I have the 3 Fatal Frame games, and I never got into them. I was thinking about maybe doing Fatal Frame 3 or something. Another idea... Eventually I'm gonna have my brother send me a PS1 version of Clock Tower. I haven't played that in a very long time. Getting all the patterns here. There we go. Alright, let's take care of this nuisance. Have a lower ground here, easier to attack him. Just go away. Please. Let's go away. Oh my god, this thing. Got a hidden staircase there? I guess I'm supposed to go that way. What was up there? A heart? Yeah, whatever. Gives me a Castlevania Bloodline sort of feel as well. Rug Master here. Thank you. Oh. Uh-oh. Whoa. Alright, easy enough. Oh. Ah, that wasn't so bad. Whip it. Stage 8, Final Fantasy 8, here we go. Sparkster, snap out of it. Sparkster is so good. I wish I actually, I would love to live stream Rocket Knight. I have that one for my Genesis. I never really gotten far in it. I think that'd be a really fun stream to do. Alright, Spider, get out of here. I forget how long this game is, so like, it's been a while. What a jerk. Difficulty does make it longer. It really does, yeah. Constant. He tries. Okay. Nope. Alright, got that just in time. Thank you. Really? Aw, oh, come on.
This game, yo. Got four lives. I sort of know what I'm doing at this point. Am I really though? Oh, see that? That was so intended for that to happen. I did not intend that. Or that. See, it wasn't actually the library level that I was going to use. This one. Oh god. Yeah, let's use that stopwatch for what it's worth. Die already. Just die. There we go.
that'd be the worst of it. That's a cool level. Backgrounds. Oh, I recall the stairs here collapsing. Oh god! Oh my god. What was that? Go there. My last life too. Oh, no, I'm not on. I have two more lives. Not my favorite life. Have that clock back. Exactly. Alright. Not messing with you. Getting out of here. Boy, this level sure loves its spike traps. Better, guys. Ooh. Alright, bring him on.
Frankenstein's monster!
Got two of them? Epic pose. I see you like to live on the edge. Indeed I do. Yeah, the peeping eyes are the worst. Oh my god. They're so annoying. Sorry. Breathing in. I'm pulling an anti-Tate Zunday with this microphone business right now. I need to stand up. Oh my god. Oh, that feels good. Alright, treasure room, here we go. Oh, is kind of a neat area, from what I recall.
Whoa.
Fun little track, too. Less spooky. Why don't we just, like, steal all the gold and then run away? That failed.
Money bin. That he jumps into it just like Scrooge McDuck.
Whoa. I like that sound effect.
That's like so many changes.
The end of doing time.
No!
That was a fail. And that was a fail, too.
I will rob Dracula
of his life.
Again.
I don't know, guys, I'm just thinking of, you know, like, settling down my whip business, you know?
D-E-D, dead. Silly skeletons.
Heavy hitters too, jeez. Not a fan.
All those worthless Dracu dollars.
Yeah, I hear the Dracu dollar to Bison dollar exchange rate is through the roof right now.
Yeah.
Truthfully, this is how I always have played Castlevania 4. I don't play it enough to memorize certain patterns and stuff. Oh god, here we go. My curse is that I easily forget the patterns that keep tripping me up.
How the drums kick in here. Very cinematic.
Castle is a creature of chaos, yes.
Currently driving me chaotic. There we go.
There, that's all I had to do.
Me
good. Yeah.
That's pretty satisfying.
Skeletons.
Oh no!
That was close. Where would I be with without the residual width? Despite all the chaos, I still have to moonwalk.
Ooh.
Still have to moonwalk backwards. Or moonwalk. Crap, I forgot that. Forgot about this segment. Kind of crazy. There isn't a golden axe, yeah. Then it plays the golden axe theme, and then the second theme. Oh, great games. Anything down there? Why would you even want to go down there? Got a life, yes! That's exciting. That's what I was hoping for with all this money I've been collecting. Curiosity, this is completely off topic. Wait, are any of you using Windows 10 right now? Because my Windows 7 sadly has been corrupted in many ways. I can't tell if it's just a bad hard drive or not. It's probably the hard drive, honestly, but I may have to reinstall Windows 7, but I'm also like, well, maybe I could just get Windows 10 and upgrade with the times, but and I have Windows 10 as a dual boot on my MacBook, and I think it's okay, but I am concerned about compatibility with, like, my older programs and stuff. So, you guys have it. Love hear your opinions. Oh, boss time. I'll look at the comments later. Oh god. Isn't this fabulous? thing. Oh god. Uh-oh.
Ah, jerks.
So close.
Ah, back here, too.
This is my last life. Ah. I got this. Collect enough wealth to get another life or strategy down here. Just always stay under it, no matter what. Though it does make a mad dash at one point, so I gotta watch out for that. Like that. Yes, I did it. I freaking did it. Oh my god. That's really something. Oh. Oh man, I think I know where this is leading me. Ah, so good. I love that little reference to Bloody Tears. So good. Clock Tower, Bloody Tears. Oh man, this is like the ultimate pump up music. Like, you can do it. Yep. Zip snap, zip snap. Oh. Rental Floss fans, think of the lyrics for this.
I love it.
I'm gonna find a place, I'm gonna sneak it up, sneak it up. I'm gonna find a rest and I'm gonna kick it. That was intentional. Anyway, I need more lives. Mood ruined. Right. I got this. But before he was slain, Dracula first.
Of course.
That part's great. Brent is a funny dude. I don't know what. Besides him working on this game that another friend of mine is making called Use Your Words. I don't know if he's been. I haven't been keeping up with his other stuff, but I've been still doing those videos or not. I'm not impressed. But I do know he's working on a game. Simon's Quest is one of the few Castlevania games where I didn't have a guide. If I wasn't looking at a strategy guide every 5 seconds, I never would have completed that game. That game needs a remake, like, so bad. Like, I appreciate Simon's Quest for what it did, but it's just so tough to follow. Oh, you did Undertale. I think I saw that one. Yeah, the game he's working on is on Steam Greenlight. Use Your Words. I highly recommend checking it out. Ooh, see that coming. He's working on it with a friend of mine, Julian, who I worked with Julian on a Mystical Ninja starring Goemon remix, which is part of an N64 tribute album that I was on. Highly recommend you check it out. It's called Tribute Album 64. It's a free album. And that is my shameless plug for this stream. I put a link on the Twitch page here. You probably see it. But we did a Goemon song for you. And that's about it for me. I hear you, man. Thanks for sticking it out when you could. Appreciate it. I might be able to beat this. I don't know. Maybe I have it in me. I might beat this tonight. We'll see. We'll see how I'm feeling by the end of it. I don't recall Dracula being too difficult, so. Ooh. I really should start uploading my. Oh god. Oh god. I should start uploading my Twitch videos to YouTube or something. Oh, I plug shamelessly enough as it is. Yeah, definitely check out the N64 album. It's got a lot of amazing tracks on it. If you're an N64 guy, you'll really appreciate it. Ooh. Ah. Somebody get rid of this bone dragon. Like that, right? Oh my god. Big problem. All right. Now what? Oh no. only reps. Only reps.
Ah, lame.
Man, holy water would have been nice right about now. Mm-hmm. This looks like a foot. I know it's a clock. Knocked me off. Jeez Louise, how do I... What the heck? This is nice. Oh, I see. Got it. Alright, respawn like right here. Oh no, that's not where I want you to respawn. Crap. Ah. Hey, Tarodia, thanks for hopping on, man. Yes, this music is super good. I'd be hearing it a lot more if I wasn't dying all the freaking time. Okay, I got this. Do this. Oh, okay. Start over there, why don't you? Right here, come on. Yeah. Exactly where I want you to be. Shoot! Ah, crap. I didn't expect that to happen. Alright, let's try this again. Yes. No, that's doing anything with this side. Doing any damage. Ah. Alright. Got this. Yeah. I did it. Alright. Not too far now. I think the next stage is either Vampire Killer or Beginning. Vampire Killer. I got him this time, indeed I did. So good. I love how this game just like... honors the previous Castlevania's 1, 2, and 3 so well. pretty. Oh, so pretty. Yeah. I have zero lives, so I'll just continue. Oh no. Running. This is pretty epic right now. Oh god.
Keep going.
Alright. Oh no. Beginning, yes. Oh, but why did it have to be played during this segment? I think this is one of my favorite personal Castlevania tunes. Good. It's so much fun to drum to as well. Crap. Well, I just screwed myself, didn't I? Yep. Alright, goodbye. Anyway, I could use the life renewal. Alright, here we go. Hey, you. Love that piano. Nice touch. Let me get a good job to me. Yeah. Definitely not. Oh. Okay. Note to self, don't do that. Oh my god, get out of here. So good during this part. Oh my god, what is going on here? Oh god. There we go.
so crazy.
Still being chased by that goblin?
Probably. Oh, that sucks. That's a toughie. That is tricky. Tricky as all. On earth am I supposed to do that part? Oh no! Ah, that sucks. Don't got this. Alright, last life. Yeah, I'm gonna redo that. Don't nearly have enough lives. I don't even remember what the boss is for this. Damn it! I fell for it again. I really shouldn't. Stop. All right, this part.
dare you. Oh my god, what happened? Honestly, my left wrist feels like... Oh my god. My left wrist right now is like ready to fall off. Oh. Probably. Probably explains my ineptitude. Last time I played this was November 1st, 2014. Death right there. Welcome all newcomers. Come at the right time. Oh my god, I'm so loading that. Come at the perfect time of me absolutely sucking at Castlevania. Sorry, I keep reloading this because know how you can get the axe without destroying the staircase. There we go. Wait, I get it now. Okay, I understand it now. So what if I go up here? It's quicker. Oh, well, there wasn't another platform I could jump to. How destroying a staircase lose yourself in this level. Shining force, oh my goodness. I really need to go out. I do have that Sonic Genesis collection. I keep making the same mistake here. What happens when you're like playing along and you're doing well, and then you mess up, and then you're messing up repeated attempts. I did it again. I swear I'm pressing up on that. Thank you. hitting up, and it's not taking it. What is going on here? At this rate, I'm not sure if I'll be able to finish. Yeah. Alright, I think I'm gonna give this one last go, and then call it there. Clearly my fingers can't keep up here. Anyone get mad at me if I stayed up here? I think I'm just gonna do it. Give me the option for save states. Might as well use them, right? Alright, yeah, let's save state right here. Yeah, because my mind is going numb from redoing that section over and over. I've done it without save states before, so I ain't proving myself here. Seriously, though, what are you... Oh. Got it. Yes. Oh, yes. Yes. Okay. This part is intense. I am so creating a restore point here. Are you kidding? There we go. This guy's a little nuts. Kinda looks like a Chozo. Close though. Yeah, slow bro. I only remember his name and how rough he is. Oh, how crazy the music is. Yeah, I don't really know Slogra's really either. Slogra sounds more like a name of a kaiju than anything. In fact, this demon itself looks like a kaiju. I other thing. I guess it's every other attack. Damn. Dracula found a pterodactyl skull and put it on a monster. That sounds about right. I think it's just this and then it's Dracula, so I'm pretty close. I'm not really sure about the strategy after he goes into claw mode. It really changes it up there. Maybe I just keep going back and forth. Oh god, really? There's Gaivon, Jeff, and then... Oh my god. We'll see how I'm feeling after this boss. I got a solid pattern in here. Oh, that is an epic death. Did you see that? That was so cool. Oh my god. Oh wait, this is death, isn't it? Or no, Gaivon? No, this is death. Oh, Gaivon, yes. Ever beat this as a kid. Ooh. Oh god. I got a good strategy now. Slow roll is easy. Cheesy. Except for that. Slow roll looks like he'd fit better in that slow game. Oh my god. Only RNG decides to look at him. Thank you. such a cool animation though, I love that. I hope there's a GIF of that somewhere. Yeah, I'm gonna save here. No ifs, ands, or buts. God, what is his deal? I just keep following him like this. He does this thing. He's extra mad. Now death, right? Better give me some frickin' chicken for that. Oh my god. Zero health. Yes, alright. I won't save here, because we're dead. Which guy but with less. For too long, jeez. Thank you. teabag, teabag. Sickles, I think I have an idea. I should, like, maybe focus on dodging the sickles for now.
Death.
God. Well, this is it. We've reached it. We've reached the end. Oh my God. Oh, this part is so good. This is my favorite part right here. Ready for this? Oh, what's this? Oh, yes, thank you. Yep. Hell yeah. Oops. That was unintentional. Yeah, let's save here. Right. We got this, guys. So nice for doing that. There we go. Restore point. We're good to go. Anyway, Death's pattern, once you figure it out, is very easy. You have to learn not to really focus on attacking and throwing sickles at you. So, anyway, that secret is the best. If I remember this pattern.
Dracula!
Damn it. Oh, it splits. Ah, I got it. Oh, what is this? I don't remember some of these attacks at all. Sailing. God damn it, why do we... It's a really tricky jump. Really tricky. There we go. Save there. Step further. We'll save right here. But in the interest of time. There. Any screw-ups, I restart that. Ready for you, Mr. Drac. Dodge that. Maybe I should just wiggle my whip out. Ooh. Oh, nice. I turned into a chicken. That's so nice. Fry guys are not cool. Not a fan of those fry guys. Alright. Try this again. Again and again and again and again. Really? Lamers. Try that again, shall we? Guys are
No, this is the most benevolent Dracula in the history of it. Oh god, this is it. This is the epic part right here.
Silent
prayer. Oh, he's really mad. Oh my god. Right there. Yeah, sucker. Die. Die, monster. You don't belong in this world. Oh, yeah. Me too. I did it. I've never beaten this game in one sitting before. That's probably longer than it should have been. Ah, so good. Look at them graphics. Look at them thighs, them glutes. Drac got dunked. Ah, this is such a good ending theme. I love this ending theme. Very melancholy. Now he's dead forever, right? Heck, he'll never come back. That's right, they used real names in the credits. I forgot about that. Okay, maybe they didn't. They're still using aliases for some people. Great game, it's I love this swelling here. I think it's coming. Right here. So good. Belmont's 60% of the time, killing Dracula would every time. Ipon? Here, enjoy. Remember all these places you were in? Had the whip set to see you. DRAM designer. I think I'm good on playing this one for another few years. That was an easy boss. That was my favorite boss because it was good. Masanori Dachi, yes, he is one of the composers of this game, as is Taro Kudo, I believe, both worked on it.
Castlevania is amazing. This is one of the top tier ones, I think. That's a nickname. I'm pretty sure it's not Okugo, not Soji. They were all using some kind of alias there. That was the voice of Simon grunting. That's what it's referring to. I believe that was the director my roommate knows. Back here, remember this? Now play the game again. Yay. Except now it's harder. Take more damage. Oh, you see that skull? That's pretty cool. I never realized that. All these crazy awesome details of this game. Anyway, that was Castlevania 4. I am up for other suggestions, as I don't have my PS1 disc of Clock Tower with me right now. I do have Clock Tower 3. I could give that a shot, or I also have Fatal Frame. What else I got here, maybe? Do I have anything spooky? Demon's Crest is great. One of my favorites, but I beat that not too long ago, so everything else here isn't quite spooky for Metroid coming. But, yeah, I'm up for suggestions on the next Halloween-esque game to play. I'm thinking of Fatal Frame, but maybe I'll throw a Twitter poll. So be on the lookout on my Twitter. It's at Patrick Cool. And yeah, this has been a Super Castlevania 4 Oops Haagen-Dazs stream. Thanks again. Check out my N64 tribute album. In the links on the Twitch page. Thank you so much. Shoutouts to Rockin' Chocobo, Mega Drive BP, Rodia, and Kojiro_S for sticking around. Thank you. Have a good night. Stay spooky.